perspective on that.
Sure.
Given what the president said about Secretary of State Tillerson's outreach from the weekend, does the president still have confidence in him as Secretary of State?
He does, yes.
He's probably to him since those outreaches.
I believe so. I'll have to verify. John?
Thanks a lot, Sarah. It's a very sad day in this country. As you mentioned at the top, as the president said in his remarks, he said that when he goes out to Las Vegas, he's going to be with first responders and, in addition to that, families of the victims that were impacted by this. What's the message to each of those groups when he goes out there?
Look, I think it's very simple to say that his goal is simply to be there to show the support of people from around the country and to stand united in not only this act of evil, but it was all acts of evil. And that he was clear to the president's remarks today, and some things are given this week, that this is a new Jessica.
I don't know if it's about to be here over the weekend. President, we can say no to your own, what has to be done. So is it the stated position of the White House that you're trying to get back to talks, or have you given up?
No, this is, we've been clear that now is not the time to talk. The only conversations that have taken place or that would be on bringing back Americans who have been detained like that with Otto. Those were the type of conversations that this administration was willing to have. Beyond that, there will be no conversations with North Korea at this time. There are three Americans still detained in North Korea.
Lines of communication with Pyongyang, that's what you're primarily using for. You're not using it to try to get them
that would, your that, that would be the only reason for us to have conversations with them at this time. There's a difference between talking and putting diplomatic pressure. We still strongly support putting diplomatic pressure on North Korea, which we're continuing to do. But now is not the time simply to have conversations with North Korea. We've encouraged all of our allies and partners to do more, and we're going to continue to keep all options on the table when it comes to that. Stephen?
Today as well. You talked about how now is not the time to get into a gun control debate or to talk about policy. After the Orlando shooting, the president that day was out on Twitter talking about policy. He was talking about his travel ban. So when, for example, Senator Chris Wilkie says it's time for Congress to get off his ass and do something, does the president
actually agree with them that Congress should get up and do something? I'm not sure that it's specific to that, but I think Congress has had several months of doing very little, and we'd like to see some actual legislation come through.
What would the president like to see Congress do is the question I would get
out. Again, we haven't had the moment to have a deep dive on the policy part of that. We've been focused on the fact that we had a severe tragedy in our country, and this is a day of warning, a time of bringing our country together, and that's been the focus of the administration this morning.
At that day, he was talking about the travel ban, saying he didn't want the graduation, essentially. Why?
There's a difference between being a candidate and being a president.
I do want to ask, before last night's announcement, the bill was advancing through the House. Republicans cleared it through the House Committee on Natural Resources that would, among other things, make it easier for people to buy silencers. Hillary Clinton tweeted about it this morning. She said that, imagine the deaths in Las Vegas if a shooter had a silencer, which the NRA wants to make easier to get. The White House have a position on this particular piece of legislation?
Again, I haven't spoken with the president about that specific issue, but I don't think that that is something that would have changed. Again, I think before we start trying to talk about the preventions of what took place last night, we need to know more facts. Right now, we're simply not at that point. It's very easy for Mrs. Clinton to criticize and to come out, but I think we need to remember the only person with blood on their hands is that of the shooter. And this isn't a time for us to go after individuals or organizations. I think that we can have those policy conversations, but today it's not that bad.
Are there any policy prescriptions that the president considers to be out of bounds on the policy debate that we've got in the next few weeks? If you articulate the important position on gun control,
the president's been clear that he's a strong supporter of the Second Amendment, and I don't have anything further at this point. I'll take one more question. Fred?
A couple questions. One, I have a question for Peru. I asked about the bill regarding the AI, which would give a permanent exemption to Puerto Rico for the Jones Act. Would the administration consider either a permanent repeal of the Jones Act?
Oh, you've got your mouse.
We certainly support religious freedom and would ask that Congress also support that as well. As you all know, we've got a moment of silence taking place on the South Lawn here momentarily, and so with that, I'll close. And just again, I think we ask collectively that everyone across the country keep the people both in Las Vegas.
Last night. In addition, you know, the White House is dealing with a lot of devastation from